Hi, how's everybody doing today? Taylor Dunn coming at you from Team Cheddar. Today I'm actually going to be going over and showing you probably the most used tool in our Amazon business today, and that is going to be Keepa. Now, you may be new to this, you may have never heard of Keepa before. What I'm going to do in this video is I'm going to give you an overview of what Keepa is, how it works, and then show you actually how we use it in our business and how we set up our Keepa charts to give us all the important data and also to leave out the stuff that's not important to us. So right off the bat, I'm gonna show you we're at Keepa.com. This is their homepage. Now Keepa is spelled K-E-E-P-A. You just type that in Keepa.com. It'll bring you to this page. And if you need to download the extension, just come over here to the apps portion of the homepage. Find your browser that you like using, select it. Then you will be taken to a new window where it will prompt you to download the extension and add it to your browser. Go ahead and do that. I already have it downloaded on my computer and everything's set up. So what we're actually gonna do right now is I'm gonna hop on over to an Amazon listing. I'm gonna show you how the Keepa extension works. And then again, give you an overview of how we use it in our business today. So hopping on over to the Amazon page, you'll see right here, I'm on Amazon. And you'll scroll down. We're looking at a nice little cool looking Nerf gun. And when you have the Keepa extension downloaded, you'll see this chart that comes up on every single Amazon listing. Now, right now this chart's blank because I'm going to be showing you all the options and how you can use them. But you'll see this here if you have the extension downloaded correctly. Now what this is this is going to be all this chart will be everything that you possibly need to understand price history of an item, what the high price has been, what it possibly can be selling at, competition, and all that good stuff. So I'm just going to start right up here where it says Amazon, and I'm going to select this button, turn it on. And when I do that, you'll see this orange line and how it's shaded right here. Now what that represents is Amazon. When has Amazon themselves been in stock on this item, and for how long of a period of time, and for how much money? So you'll see that in the last 3 months, you'll see right down here I have my dates. In the last 3 months, Amazon was on this product. They were selling it for $25.35. I can even extend this out to a year, or I can even do the all time, which on this particular product is over 1,000 days. So I can select that, and it will show you all, and you'll see the dates right here below. It'll show you when Amazon was in stock, how much, and how much they were selling that item for. Now I can also that's Amazon. Now if I come over here and I select the new button, what that's going to now show me, and I'm going to turn off Amazon, what that's now going to show me is what price this item was selling for brand new before any shipping costs were taken into consideration. Okay, so that's very important. Before shipping costs, that this blue line will tell you what the new price offer was. All right, so and we'll go over into shipping costs a little bit later. It'll show you that some more information, but that's what this blue line is here for. And I'm gonna go ahead and turn that off. Now you have the used option. Now used will show up, and it's kind of hard to see, but you'll see these black lines. That's gonna be the used price for, so at what time was this item selling for at a new price, at a used price. Now I particularly don't use any used prices in our business, so I don't ever turn this option on. If you are in the habit of selling used items on Amazon, this is going to be very helpful for you to understand where you should probably price your item at depending on condition. So let's go ahead and turn it off. Then right down here you'll see sales rank. Now sales rank is extremely important. If you don't know what sales rank is, Amazon puts a rank for every item that is on Amazon.com. It's called the best seller rank, and it essentially will tell you out of all the products in that particular category, how good is this product, how quickly is it selling. So the lower the number, the better the sales are. So again, we're looking for a low number. In different categories, this can mean a whole different thing. Under 100,000 rank in toy is completely different than under 100,000 rank in a category like home improvement. This is because toy is only so large of a category, and home improvement is a much larger category. So sales rank is dependent on the category. There'll be other videos that will come out that will explain about this more in depth and what you should be looking out for, and also other tools that you can use to help understand sales rank better. Right now with Keepa, this sales rank will just tell you the rank below. Now you'll see right here, you'll have your chart pull up 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. This will differ. Well, this will change depending on the product and what sales rank it sits at. So we'll go about this a little bit later, but that's the sales rank. Now, list price, you'll see it just says brown right up here. List price is what the recommended manufacturer retail price is. So this is what Nerf, for instance, for this product, because we are looking at a Nerf gun, this is Nerf will look at this and say this product is $27.99 retail MSRP. Again, this can be helpful depending on the strategy you're using for your business. We use the list price every once in a while, but not very often because we are Amazon FBA primarily in our arbitrage business. So I'm only going to really gonna be competing with those offers, but if you need it, that's the list price. There's also collectible. So again, if you're selling in a collectible category or you're selling the product as a collectible used item, you'll see the pricing history there. New third-party FBM. Okay, it'll come up as these little blue squares. Now, what the new party FBM is the new selling price. So I'm going to let's pull up that. The new selling price, which is that blue line, plus any shipping costs that are added to that. So say a merchant fulfill seller is selling their product for $25.35. After that's their selling price for the item, there's an additional charge for shipping, and you'll see right here that the third-party FBM seller is actually selling this product for $36.85. That means that they're selling it, they're advertising it as a $25.35 for the product, and an additional roughly about $11 in shipping costs. That is important to remember because when you're looking at your competition, if you're an FBA seller like I am, you're not worrying about the price of shipping. You get to take advantage of the two-day free shipping through Amazon Prime. But your merchant fulfill offers are going to be competing with you, and you can know that, hey, you know, even though they're advertising at $25.35, there's an additional $11 for shipping. I can price mine at that higher price because my shipping is free for the customers, so I can take that into consideration when I'm looking at my competition. You'll see right down here, right below the new third-party FBM is the new third-party FBA. Now the new third-party FBA will come up as little red triangles. Okay. Now this is going to be, if you're using Amazon FBA as your fulfillment method for your Amazon business, this is going to be your direct competition. So I always have these red triangles popped up on all my Keepa graphs. So that way I know who is my competition. What are they selling their price at? I don't worry about merchant fulfill offers very often. I'm normally just going to be competing with the FBA offers. That's what these little red triangles are for. Now you'll have the buy box selection. So if I turn that on, let me turn off a couple of these a little bit easier to see. You'll see these little pink diagonals. Now what that represents is what is the price that is getting the buy box. So you'll see, and there's a lot of information right here, but you'll see right next to my mouse cursor, buy box is $25.35. So somebody was selling that price for $25.35. They had the buy box. So again, I use the buy box when I'm looking at a product, especially when I'm repricing my inventory to see, okay, well, who is successfully having the buy box at what price and can I compete at that level? Okay. Then there's eBay stuff. I'm not going to get into the eBay new or the eBay used. If you are an eBay seller, go ahead and check this out, play around with it. You're probably going to understand. It's going to give you all the eBay information, but we are primarily looking just for Amazon. All right, so that is going to be the upper chart right here. The upper chart is all about your price and sales rank, okay? Now, you'll see down here, I have another chart open. You may not see this on your webpage, and the reason for that is because you have the more historical data right there turned off, okay? So when you have it turned off, you're only going to be seeing pricing information. Now, we always look at the more historical data because it tells us a lot of important stuff. And first off, it's going to be the new offer count. Now, the new offer count is how many sellers are selling this particular item. How many different offers are there for this item? Now, this is really important when you're trying to understand competition and sales velocity. Because if you find an item that is that sells really well, say it sells roughly 50 times a month, but yet there's 50 offers currently on it, you know that you're sharing the buy box with a lot of competition, it may change the way you might look at a product and whether or not you want to make that purchase decision. So again, I use the new offer account. It's pretty much the only thing we use in our business for this lower chart. There is other information out there that you can use, and I'm going to show you in a second, but this is pretty much what you're looking at right now is how I always have my Keepa chart set up, whether I'm on the road doing some RAing or if I'm at home on my computer going through my buy list or my my OA cheddar list and making online purchases. This is how I have my Keepa set up. I have my new offer account, my buy box, third-party FBA, third-party FBM, sales rank, new price, and if Amazon and my Amazon setup. Okay, so you can see, you'll see the filters and what I have up here. Now, you may find some Keepa charts that don't have nearly this much information on it. They're not all products are built, or all products are the same on Amazon, and sometimes Keepa doesn't have all that information like they do on this one. Now, Keepa does a really good job gathering information and being up to date on all the different products on Amazon, but there's just a whole bunch of products. So sometimes you may have, you know, the new price Amazon and the FBA, but you don't have any used prices or anything like that. Don't worry about that. This is going to be pretty much the only settings you're going to need for 99% of your business. like I said before, you have the used offer count. So if I'm looking at used, I can see, you know, how many used offers there may be. Collectible offer count, same thing. I can see how many sellers are selling this as in a collectible setting. Now there's also the rating one, which will come down as this turquoise line to show you what the average star rating has been on this product over its lifespan. I don't really use that too much. It is helpful if you are looking at a product and it has low reviews. You can investigate and see why. Is it a faulty product? Things like that. But there's other tools that I use to look at reviews and stuff like that. So, and then of course you have a review count, which it shows up as this green line up here. It will tell you how many reviews the product has had over its time on Amazon. Again, I don't really look at that when I'm researching a product because I don't find that that's extremely helpful. Now, if I'm doing like private label or something like that, that can be extremely helpful. And that's a whole nother strategy that we'll get into at a later date. So as of right now, you'll see that how I have my Keepa chart set up. Now you have this range in time. Now Keepa will let you look at as short as a day, a week, a month, 3 months, a year, and then at the all time. So however long they have data on this particular item, it will show you the whole history of it, all of which are important. I use each different time differently when I'm looking at a product. So if I might want to see, okay, well, in the last month, how has this product been selling? I can look at that by searching. It will pretty much always pop up as a 3 month history when you are first opening up the product listing. So again, I use all these different time frames depending on what I'm looking at. Like say in the last year, I want to see, well, how is this product done in the last year? And I can look at that. I can see the offer count, you know, when the offers were low, what was the price at? Was it higher? You know, as of right now, this product is declining in offers and the price is starting to raise back up. Looks like Amazon went out of stock roughly about a month ago. They were in stock for about a month and a half and then went out of stock. Offer counts low is dropping, the price is starting to raise. This is a good time to be selling this product. So again, I use the times for all different setups. Now, when I'm first reviewing a product, especially if I'm doing online arbitrage and I'm at home at my computer, it makes it very easy to read these graphs. I can look and I can say, okay, in the last 3 months, this product was selling, Amazon was selling this product actually. So in the last 3 months, Amazon was selling this product, they've been out. Okay, well now, okay, looks like the price has jumped up dramatically from $25 to about $58 FBA. I'm seeing the offer counts lowering. That's giving me good confidence knowing that the competition's leaving, which means the price is just gonna continue to rise more often than not. But what I can do is I can look at the last year and see what was the product selling for when Amazon was not in stock. And I can see the product was selling for around $71 and it was still selling very quickly. You'll notice the sales rank right down here is changing, but it's pretty much under 20,000 in most scenarios. Looks like the offers did start to rise, price dropped, so that is helpful information when I'm looking at a product of, you know, how many am I gonna, do I wanna buy? You know, I'm weighing my options with the competition. Again, you see Amazon came in. So all this information is helpful. The other thing I can do is I can actually go onto the chart, click, highlight a section. So say I want to know in between June 17th and roughly June 7th what this product was doing. I can do that and it will zoom into that specific time. Now, when I do that, first thing I notice just even looking at this is that Amazon was in stock for a few times. You see how this price is a flat line and then it drops down suddenly? Well, if I hover over that, I see that Amazon, it'll be the little orange box, was selling this product for $26.49. But they sold whatever inventory they had and they immediately went out of stock extremely quickly. So that happened here. I can see that it happened right here. And it happened again. Again, that might tell me different information. Maybe Amazon is just running out of inventory and this is the last little bit that they have. Again, you have to weigh that decision and make that choice on whether or not you want to purchase the item based off of all the information that you have available to you. Again, I hope this was helpful. This is just the overview of Keepa. This is how we set up for our business. Again, you'll see the filters that I have turned on. Real quick note, you may see on the sales rank that you can flip it depending on how you like to look at the information. So if you want 0 for the sales rank to be at top, so the higher up the line is, the better the sales rank, you can look at it this way, or you can swap it around to where the low number is at the bottom, high number is at the top, and the sales rank spiking down indicates sales. So I like to look at it this way. You can change it up however you want. I hope you found this video was helpful. If you have any questions, please feel free to give us a call, to leave us a comment below. If you enjoyed this information and you want more, please subscribe to our channel. We're going to be coming out with more information about our Amazon FBA and different tools and how you can use them. If you are an Amazon seller and you are looking for opportunity and leads, let me direct you to our online arbitrage lead list, OA Cheddar. I'll put the links below. Other than that, you all have a great rest of your day and thank you for watching. Bye-bye.